That's a lot of ships.
Looks like Vaylin sent her entire fleet.
Where's the gravestone?
Odessen, I need a status report. Now.
Vaylin caught us with our bridges down.
Still installing the new upgrades. Gonna take a few minutes before we're in the air.
Ground forces are holding the line until the gravestone's up. But we're outnumbered and outgunned.
Hold tight, Bay-1. Help is on the way.
You and Lana can lead the charge. I'll do more damage if I slip behind enemy lines.
Sounds like a good plan to me.
I specifically ordered this battle to end quickly.
The Alliance is showing unexpected resistance. We still have the advantage, but the price of victory will be high.
Then pay it! Arkan is here. Mother, father, the Outlander. I will paint Odessen with their blood.
Right. Time to go save the world again. Quite a distance. They are not fucking about. Oh sweet, I can use my speeder. Sorry guys, you are not that important.
We could use more firepower. Maybe we can find something to clear a path through this battle.
Do I have to? This way, not this way, that way.
I will not fail!
Why do they feel the need? This one, homing missiles, yeah, that'll do. Come on then. Where are we going? Is it this way? Yeah, near enough. I like how I'm just ignoring. Oh shit, this way.
That's far enough, Outlander.
Why can't I just skip all of this shit? Yeah, I'll do. Come on.
Hold the line. This way. Enemy reinforcements coming in from the west.
This way? No? Okay, I've gone completely the wrong way, and that's probably going to kill me.
Okay.
I might just get out of this. Right, let's heal up a little bit before we go anywhere. At least they didn't follow me the entire way. Alright, fuck it, that'll do. And I cannot be arsed. Normally, because it gives me command points, I'm like, yeah, let's do all of the side missions, but if I'm in these bloody walkers, then that can frankly go to hell. That far away. That looks a lot like no targeting range.
That's far enough, Outlander.
Oh, for goodness sakes. Overall, I have really enjoyed this bit of DLC, but I loathe vehicle sections in any games, but especially in this, because it handles like a pissed cow, and it's just not very good.
Status update.
Mando reinforcements heading Baywan's way.
Figured you'd be in the middle of the action.
This is what we live for. No way we're sitting this one out.
My students and I sought to defend the gravestone. Enemy artillery slowed our progress.
I got this. Ogurov gave me some toys to take out their big guns.
I love you, Vet.
Does Ogurov have any other fancy gadgets we could use?
Everything was deployed with the troops. Now he's busy securing the base, keeping the enemy away from his research. Don't worry, though. I got everything I need to smash Vaylin's artillery.
If we hit the enemy forces from behind, we buy the gravestone some time.
Right. At least I'm not on one of those stupid bloody vehicles anymore. Actually make some proper progress. Is he on my side? He doesn't look like he should be on my side. But I think he is on my side. Hey, what up, Mr. Sith Lord? Nice one. Going into something of a game and not knowing what happens. Like, when I've done stuff with Mass Effect and what have you, like, I know Mass Effect. I know what happens. I've played it so many times. There's not really any possible surprise that I could have left. And, oh no, not another hissing vehicle. Good. I don't think that's me in another vehicle. Thankfully. But yeah, not knowing what happens, it is quite... It's its own reward in a way. I'm not used to not knowing things. That's terribly arrogant. But what I mean is, about, like, stuff that I play and what have you, like, I tend to go kind of all in with the stuff up. I'm not overly fussed about spoilers and what have you. I understand why people are. I get the enjoyment of being surprised. But the way I see it is that I've know it eventually, so what does it matter? Oh, for God's sake, I wish it would... I don't even know where these guys were. It's not even a bloody... Right. But yeah, like, you figure out, you know what's going to happen eventually, and I know that finding it out in the way that it's meant to be found out is something in itself, but I don't really care. Get there in the end.
They're swarming me. I need more time.
Wonder if any of my people will die.
Senya and I are close. We won't let them take the ship.
Nice one, Arkan. I like the changes they made to Senya's character model for this expansion. She looks like someone's mother now. Before, she kind of looked like their sister. Which means she didn't look very old. Now she kind of looks a bit wrinkled, a bit worn. Send you time to kick some ass.
Arkan and I are at the gravestone.
Welcome back to the land of the living, Senya.
It's good to be back. And now I get to thank you for all you've done for me and for Arkan. It's time to repay our debt.
Another wave incoming!
Can you and Arkan hold your positions?
We can try, but without reinforcements.
We can't lose the gravestone. We're on our way.
Yeah, that is really our priority, because it's the only way we've got, the only chance we've got of taking out their fleet. Because that thing packs one hell of a punch. Where's my mouse cursor gone? There it is. His health went down really quickly before I started attacking, and then it seemed to go down really slowly. That was a bit strange. Do that. Oh, worked out really well for you. Come on. Not far to go now. Damn. So I was thinking about this yesterday, actually. How I'm not really very excited for Rogue One, which I find very surprising. Loved Episode 7, thought it was incredible. And I like the premise of Rogue One, but nothing I've seen...
Gravestone much longer. Come on.
Nothing I've seen has really ticked any boxes for me. Really quite disappointed, which is a shame. I don't particularly like these movie spin-offs just on principle. I couldn't give a toss about the Han Solo one. I just don't care. I've never been a huge Han Solo fan anyway. But, yeah, it's kind of surprised me just how little... How much I don't care. How little I'm excited for a new Star Wars film, which I think says more about the film than it does me, because I've been a fan of Star Wars since I was 3. And, you know, we went, you know, after Friend of the Sith came out, that was it. No more Star Wars films. No way there's going to be an Episode 7. And then we got an Episode 7. And now we're getting all of these extra ones. And it just feels like those stories are things that could be told elsewhere and told better elsewhere. You know, the whole stuff between, you know, the Death Star plans and all of that stuff has been told before. Why couldn't they have told the Rogue One story in Rebels? Because Rebels is great. Absolutely love it. It's one of my favourite things that has ever been with Star Wars. And it's everything that I want from the Star Wars TV show. And Rogue One could turn out to be amazing, and I could just be barking up the wrong tree. I don't think so. There's just something about it. I'm sure critics will love it. It's grittier, it's a change of pace, it ticks all of those boxes for Star Wars scores. Because the thing is, people that don't like Star Wars will like it because it's different. People that do like Star Wars will like it because it's Star Wars. It's going to be popular, and it's going to make a hell of a lot of money, which ultimately is what Lucasfilm gave
us. We couldn't have held out much longer alone.
I should have known Vaylin would attack Odessen.
At what cost, damn it?
Just like Voss, you gave us shelter, and now you're paying the price.
I helped you because I needed allies to stand against Vaylin.
We've chosen to stand with you, Commander.
We will not let Odessen fall to her.
Walkers coming our way. Too many.
I'm not getting in a fucking walker. Hopefully that means they've made the repairs.
The gravestone's better than ever.
I was worried that Koth was stealing it again.
Nice work. Now show me what those guns can do against Vaylin's fleet.
My pleasure.
The gravestone alone won't turn this battle. My sister's unleashing the full fury of the Eternal Empire on Odessen.
Time for the Sith
Conquest
to start
isn't
paying their bills.
She seeks to annihilate us. For her, this is personal.
Yep, you and me both.
She attacked my people, my followers, my friends. It doesn't get any more personal.
You need to fight Vaylin face to face. Lure her down to the surface. If she falls, the battle's over.
I'm on the enemy flank, joined up with Sana Ray. But we can use a little more firepower.
Lana, help Theron. I'm heading to the front lines. Vaylin needs to know exactly where to find me.
You won't have to face her alone. Arkan and I will join you.
I'm honored to have you fighting at my side.
The honor is ours, Commander. You've given us a chance to atone for our family's crimes. We won't waste it.
My daughter must be stopped at any cost.
Sweet. That is one thing that I don't like about the companions you get. The new ones you get for Knights of the Fallen Empire and Knights of the Eternal Throne is you can't make any adjustments to them. Like, you can't customize them at all. And that's kind of one of the things I always liked most about these games, was the ability to customize. And you could do it with, like, the old, like, for this expansion and the previous one, like, you get separated from your companions. If you recruit any new ones, or any, sorry, if you get your old companions back, or companions that were for different classes in, you know, so say, like, right, my character's a Jedi Knight, right? So you can pick up characters for companions for Sith. The Sith companion, Vett, is the Sith warrior
Corrupt's
companion.
Bringing some new toys for the troops. Let's light the enemy up.
And you can customize her appearance. But you can't with, say, Senya, who's a new companion for Knights of the Fallen Empire, the previous expansion. Which is a shame, because it just seems kind of lazy and a bit half-assed. And I get why they've done it, because it makes it a lot easier to program. You don't have to customize the appearance of these characters and what have you. It makes it a bit easier to... I have to get off of this to get in. Yeah, screw it. I'm not, why am I not able? Yeah, just seems a shame. I don't see why you can't adjust the new companions. Just seems lazy.
A gravestone has joined the battle, but our fleet numbers make victory inevitable.
Burn Odessen, and bring me the ashes. I want them for my garden.
Good fertilizer.
Father's pet. I was just talking about you.
How many of your underlings do I have to butcher? Get down here and give me a challenge.
Oh, I intend to. Now that I've broken Father's chains, I could crush you in a second. But that's too easy.
I will chew up your friends and grind your precious alliance into paste. When I finally hunt you down, you will beg me to end your suffering.
You lost face when I crashed your party on Zakul. If you want to reclaim it, meet me in battle and stop acting like a child.
You regret this.
My daughter has taken your bay.
We should clear out as many enemy troops as possible before my sister arrives.
No. Do I have to? I hate these things. I do. I hate them so much. What do you want?
Go team.
I wonder if you've recruited less companions. That is less. Or do you have at least 8? And you have to find them. I think I've just been ignoring. That was easy.
Sana Ray is leading our force users in a counter-strike against the enemy flank.
Destroying the walkers is 20 command points. It might actually make your summoner worthwhile. Why does it keep highlighting the Alliance fighters anytime I decide to? Because it makes fighting a lot harder. Oh wow, you're a big bastard, isn't you? What do these even do? I mean, I can't see him, he's bloody flying! Okay, the heavy cannon has one hell of a wallop. I'd like to check. Oh. Well, I didn't think I was anywhere near
Vaylin
killing
will
him.
Be here soon. I want status updates.
Fried those artillery guns as promised. I guess they weren't happy about it. They kinda got me pinned down. Gonna need a little help.
That's not the only one in trouble. Enemy ambush cut us off. I'm the only one left. Position's about to be overrun.
Yeah, well, I've got about 2 minutes before they squash me like a bug.
Oh, so I'm gonna have to make some
even you arbitrary choice. Everyone, Outlander.
About who lives and who dies.
Who shall live. You also choose who shall die.
Well, that was easy, because I'm really given a toss about Torian, and
Vet,
I love that.
We're coming for you.
I knew I could count on you.
I'm not afraid to die. Just didn't think I'd go out like this.
Torian does seem quite nice.
You're not dead yet, Torian. Keep fighting. After we help...
I know how this ends. Just win the war. Don't let me die in vain.
Sorry for skipping that. Bad habit.
Let's move. Vet needs our help.
Ah, the good old BioWare arbitrary choice as to who lives and who dies. And look, I bet he, Torian's down there. You know, the old fork in the road. See, that's imagery, that is. Yeah, you'd totally have been down there, wouldn't you? Bye, bitches. Oh, shit. Don't mind me.
How long do you think Vet can hold her position?
Long enough for us to get there, I hope.
Is this going to be that annoying thing where if I don't attack them, it's going to... Yeah. It is his hand. That's kind of like, I kind of want Torian to be dead, because at least it will mean that there's some degree of consequence. And after all, that's kind of what these games are about.
We're almost there.
I hope we're not too late.
Here.
Was I not meant to go under here? As long as it stops me having to fight annoying enemies. Are these enemies like half weakened before I even get near them? Because that leap took a hell of a lot of health off that knife. Why is none of these... I don't know if that's a glitch or if it was just because he was in the middle of an animation.
Survive. Not going to lie, I started to wonder if you'd make it.
I said I'd come for you, Vet. I don't break promises with my friends.
I'm grateful for that. Thank you. What about Torian?
Torian, do you copy? We're coming for you next.
Wrong again, Outlander.
Oh,
I found your Mandalorian. Now he's all mine.
You've got my attention.
Good. That was the point.
When the Outlander comes for you, Arkan and I will be at her side.
I'm counting on it, Mother. You got what you wanted. I'm on Odessen. Now let's end this.
Tell me where and I'll find you. Just let Torian go.
That isn't how this works.
I'm sending you a location. We meet.
Whoa. Feeling a bit lightheaded. I'll stay here and recover while you go smack Vaylin all the way back to Zakul.
Sounds like a good idea to me. See, I can't help but shake the feeling that Valkorion wants this. I don't know why. But I can't imagine him being happy with beings, this non-corporeal being, for long.
South perimeter has been breached! Fall back to the rally point!
You know, he is quite the badass.
Hmm.
this way. But yeah, like, Valkorion is one of the most powerful Sith there has ever been. Is he even Sith? Like, it seemed his dad was many moons ago.
I've got your back.
But yeah, like, he's kind of beyond Sith at this point. I think he's just kind of his own.
That's far enough, Outlander.
It's kind of like his own monster now. Plus, you know, he was in the body of a human man for God knows how long.
That's far enough, Outlander.
I don't think he's been Sith for a long, long time. Jedi-ish, and then also looking kind of just cool. That's what I like about this current thing that I've got, and indeed most of the Jedi armor. A lot of it looks really cool.
Sonarite forces are being pushed back. Reinforcements heading her way.
Sorry, guys. Too busy to be dealing with you. To save.
You'll be all
there.
Right.
You are, bitch. You have wrecked my shit up good and proper.
Finally, I was getting bored. And when I get bored, prisoners start losing limbs.
It doesn't matter what happens to me, Commander. Just take her down!
Let me speak to Father.
Release Torian, and I'll see what I can do.
You actually care for the life of this crawling worm? Pathetic. What did Father ever see in you? Did he really think you could steal my throne?
You are not worthy of the throne. You are not fit to rule the Eternal Empire.
I'm more deserving than your new puppet.
Motherfucker. Oh, that is it. She is so fucking dead.
She can't even protect her own people.
Now I'm going to make you suffer before you die.
Funny. I was just thinking the same thing. It must be Father's influence.
She won't stop until all your allies lie dead at her feet.
For once, I'm inclined to agree with you, Valkorion.
Even Valkorion is too scared to face me, now that my chains are broken.
We aren't afraid.
Enough blood has been spilled. This has to stop.
Do you have any last words before I end this pitiful family
reunion? I like the lightsaber.
I've given you every chance, Vaylin, but you've left me no choice. You can't be saved.
I never wanted to be.
I mean, credit where it's due, she is at least honest with herself. Holy shit! nearly a million health. Jesus. Bitch, put me down. Slow going. Good time to proc her save award.
Odessen will burn.
Gives me 6 seconds of protection from disabilities and what have you. Just work out and stun doors and not pop my feet in the way. We've got us a halfway in a couple of minutes, so. Shit.
For a puppet, you fight well. Once you fall, Odessen will burn.
I need to make sure that I'm
you're a puppet.
Not
you fight well.
In a position where I can be thrown off the edge. Because that's just a little bit of trouble.
For a puppet, you fight well. Once you fall, Odessen will burn.
You know, guys, if you wanna like heal me, that's cool.
My full power
so
has been unleashed.
Yeah, your full power is unleashed, lady. Yeah, suck it, bitch.
This isn't over. Even now, my daughter is a threat.
Oh, father, you know me so well.
Oh, dear.
I have no more power over Vaylin. Only you are strong enough to stop this.
The Eternal Throne is mine!
This isn't about the throne. It's about stopping you.
At least I can finally say what I've been saying in character for a long time. To them. Yes! I don't want her in my head. Her father's bad enough.
The Eternal Fleet just turned in and ran. The whole fleet.
Enemy lines have broken. It's a rout. They're surrendering by the thousands.
My sister's rage was the only thing giving her troops the will to fight.
Then it's over. We won.
We won.
Still another chapter to go, though. Alright. Let's not be busting out the champers just yet. I don't think this is the end. It's not, because there is another chapter to go, but I don't think that's the end of Vaylin or...
I still can't believe Torian's gone.
He sacrificed himself so our cause could live on.
We will honor his memory.
along with everyone who fell defending Odessen.
We need to talk about my sister's death. I felt something when you struck her down, like her life force flowed into you.
This happened once before, when Valkorion died.
Unlike my father, Vaylin didn't have the power to transfer his spirit to a new host. It's possible you simply absorbed her strength while her spirit was obliterated. I hope that's all it was.
I really don't want anything to do with her.
If Vaylin was alive, I think I would sense her. Like Valkorion.
Not if Father is preventing it. I have no proof, but we both know he can't be trusted. Be careful.
Commander, urgent distress call coming in from Empress Asena.
Drummond Cass is under attack. The Eternal Fleet is bombing us from orbit.
We won't abandon an ally. I'm sending our fleet, Empress, with the gravestone at its head.
It's not just the Sith who are under attack, Commander. I'm picking up urgent distress signals from Coruscant and the other core worlds.
We know Vaylin didn't order this. The Gemini captains must have gone rogue.
There's more. Emergency calls coming in from Zakuul. The Eternal Fleet set up a blockade. They're bombing them into oblivion.
I won't sit by while the Eternal Fleet wipes out billions of lives.
You cannot solve this with your armies and fleets. The Eternal Throne sits empty, leaderless. The fleet has reverted to its most primal function, extermination. Unchecked, they will destroy all life in the galaxy. There is only one way to stop them. Claim the Eternal Throne.
Can I just claim it and then order everything to be scuttled?
Ready the gravestone. We're going to Zakuul.